What up, YouTube? Today I'm going to be doing a review of three different robotic floor mops. The JetBot by Samsung, BravaJet M6 by iRobot, and the ShineBot 450 by iLife. So let's get into it.
First, going through the Samsung. Comes with two different kinds of pads. I only use this one once. This is a small microfiber pad that it has here. And then it has this supposed long-napped cleaner pad. To prep this thing, you take off these discs. The unit itself is very lightweight. You're instructed to fill up both of these. I use warm water. The instructions of everything you need to do are here. There's also a little scan that you code here for information online. And it does instruct you to take these and get these completely wet and then wring them out so that they're damp. One tip I will tell you if you get this one is to try and keep it centered all the way around. If it's slightly off-centered, one, this plastic will start to hit some of the cabinets, and two, it doesn't seem to move as well. To put them back on, you just push them in and rotate, and they'll click, and then this thing is ready to go. You can add a small amount of cleaning solution to the reservoirs. But the thing I have noticed is because this is so wet and this is so wet, it doesn't really make a big difference. I think in order for it to help, you would need to put cleaning solution in the reservoir and also on these pads. And after that, you're good to go.
The nice thing about this one is it is very quiet. It's very light, easy to move from place to place if you were going to put this in smaller rooms. As you can see though, it uses a completely random cleaning pattern. Sometimes it swirls in the middle, sometimes it goes in straight lines. It just bumps into a lot of stuff, which makes it loud overall because you do hear it hitting cabinets and hitting chairs. And I also did notice that you'll see here, this one does get stuck. Doesn't have any camera or any real logic patterns in it as to knowing where it's at, so it will get stuck on thin carpets, it'll get stuck underneath chairs. I don't know that it really cleans the entire area. It doesn't have a smart map and the pattern seems extremely random.
It doesn't come with like a charging pad or anything like that. It just comes with this base to sit it on to keep these pads from sitting on something because they're wet, and then you use the regular power adapter to plug this in to charge. Then when you take it out to use it, unplug it, take it to where you're going. Doesn't make a lot of sense to me because anytime you use this, when you're done, you're gonna be taking these pads off to clean them. So now it's, you know, it's sitting in there like that. The way this thing works is you fill this reservoir, it wicks through here to continually transfer moisture to this pad through the backing of the foam. What I've found is that these pads normally dry out before the cycle's done. And then I realized that I was doing it incorrectly. What they tell you to do is to run this. It runs for, I believe it's 50 minutes, and then it beeps, and it'll run around, and this blue light will start blinking, and it'll start making this intermittent tune. And when it does that, what it's telling you to do is to take this, take these pads off, fill them back up, supposedly wash these, and then put everything back together. You can't just put this down, set it and forget it, and let it run. It's gonna run until the battery dies, but half of that is gonna be with the dry pad. So it's not really cleaning the floors. This is the reigning champ, the Brava. I'll say reigning champ because it has some of the best reviews and people swear by it. This one is a intelligent mop. It does use a Swiffer style mop where it sprays water out from here and then uses a Swiffer style pad to push back and forth over top of the area. You'll see that whenever I run this a little bit. To get this thing started, it does come with wet reusable pads that you can wash. It comes with these dry pads, which I mean, I don't know why you would ever just use this as a Swiffer and have a robot just push dirt around your floor. But if you wanted to do that, you could use the dry pad. To get this set up for wet mop, this container comes out. Some of the features of this thing that I really do like, just simple design features. It has this flat bottom here, which allows it to sit on a surface without tipping over. It seems like a minor thing, but because you can also add a cleaning solution to this, that's very useful. And then to get this thing going, you put this back in here. The instructions are on there, obviously. Push it down until it clicks. Insert this pad on the bottom here. There's a little spot in here. It's got a sensor which you can tell which pad you're using, so it knows if it's doing dry mopping or wet mopping. You can run these through the washing machine, and you are supposed to replace these every time. When it sits on this base, it is charging, and the unit will come back to this base to recharge to make sure that it cleans the entire area. You see these little rollers here, the two contact pads to charge on the charging station. This comes on and off. It's got the sensor bumper up front, and that's where the cleaning solution slash water is squirted out in front of the unit whenever it's cleaning. Camera here to map out the area. I found that I had to run this thing twice throughout my entire house before it actually had the map of the floor laid out that you can use to delineate rooms. And it is an intelligent mop, so even though it will use these sensors to bump into obstacles within the house as they appear, like chairs and other things that might not be part of the structure, it does know your general room size and layout for mapping purposes.
This one does great as far as the intelligent features. I like that it maps out the rooms, and then you can tell it to just clean a specific room instead of cleaning all of your hardwood floors. The thing I didn't like about this one was the price point. For this price point, it is smart, it is intelligent, and it runs very quiet, and it's very good at navigating around obstacles, but you are still essentially paying for a wet Swiffer mop. It's not doing much more than it would to just grab your regular Swiffer mop with squeegee, squirt out some moisture, and Swiffer the floors. And I think at this price point, it should be doing more than that. It's great at navigation, it runs quietly, but still, it's essentially just moving dirt around.
Next up is the ShineBot by iLife. This one is completely different in the way it actually functions. This one is an actual floor mop with a suction. This is the 450 model. The 450 model has supposedly the upgraded sensor for visibility for mapping. It also allows you to dial it in the app. You could set the water usage, how much it puts down, the brush speed, and how fast the unit actually moves. That's critical, as I found that running this at a very slow speed actually sucks up a lot more of the water. I'm gonna show you how this one works. It has two power driven wheels, and then it's got a swivel wheel on the front and a swivel wheel on the back on the water container. This is the squeegee I was telling you about that sits behind the brush. This brush spins, water and soap, if you add it, gets squirted out in this bar here right in front of the brush. And it just moves across the floor, scrubbing it with this brush. And then there's a vacuum in here that actually sucks up the water through this section here. It has a filter here and then the connection for the water reservoir. You fill this one up with regular just warm water. You can add soap to it. It uses a specific type of soap, and you add a very, very small amount. And this is designed specifically for floor mops. Pre-moisten the brush. The brush clips in like so, pretty easy. Very easy, set it, forget it. The cleaning mode, you can do S cleaning, which just tries to clean everything, and then you can do an edge cleaning.
Start auto cleaning.
There you go.
This one runs very well. It's very quiet. It does bump into stuff a little bit, but because of the sensors and the camera that it has, it's not that loud. You can run it while doing other stuff. You do hear it because of the vacuum in it, but it's not so loud that you have to only run it when you're not in the house. I'll show you guys the app here while this thing is zipping around. It does map out the area that it's cleaned. And within the cleaning plan, you could set up to the cleaning frequency. I don't truly understand the cleaning versus drying, how that actually functions. I have not noticed a big difference between the setting of those at all. It gives you how much area it's clean, how long it's been cleaning for, and the battery life remaining. And as you can see, this is live when you bring up the app while the unit is actually cleaning. The big thing here is you can go into cleaning history, and you could see any times that it has cleaned, the map that it cleaned of wherever you placed it, and how long it cleaned, and then the error codes. Most of these error codes had to deal with the water reservoir. All right, so I'll give you guys another pro tip. On a piece of painter's tape on the top of this thing, I wrote down the login and the password for the app. And I also wrote down the settings that work the best for me. The reason being is probably about two or three times I've noticed that I will start this thing and it'll be running at a different speed and the settings are different. Then when I go to check the app, it's reset. I have to re-log in and then change the settings back to where they were. I kept having to redo the email address and the password because I would forget what it was because I just did something random because I didn't think I was gonna have to log in again. So I wrote it on here because I didn't want to have to reset the device up again, acting like it was a new robot, which is what you end up doing if you forget your login and your account information. When this thing runs, it appears to get its running information from the app as opposed to just doing what it did before. When the app resets and it goes back to default and it logs me out, when I run the robot, it's back to the factory settings. It's running, you know, 100% speed, 50% of the water usage, which doesn't work the best for my floors. When this is empty, you disconnect the tank. It stores dirty water in this section. This will be the remainder of what you have for the cleaner, soapy water that you put in. The cleaning of this is pretty easy. Dump out the remainder of the soapy water. This is the air filter for the vacuum side. That whole thing comes out to rinse it out. This all feeds into the dirty water tank. Pressing this down opens this valve and this valve to allow water to flow in. And I just rinse this whole thing off. There's no electronic parts on this side. Dirty water release. This whole scrubber wheel comes off. This bearing comes off. If you have pets or anything like that, you will get hair buildup on here that you can just pull off. Rinse this whole thing off. And these are replaceable. They don't last forever. It is a scrubbing brush. And that's it. The iLife actually comes with a full charging base with charging contacts. So you just set that on there. And you'll hear it. It'll say that it's going to start charging. This base also acts as a small drip tray, since there is a little bit of moisture that's going to be on the bottom of this thing after you clean it to prevent that from damaging whatever surface you have this sitting on. This is a foreign product, and like a lot of foreign products, they will update these and they will change it and they'll make upgrades to them. And there's really no version numbers or anything like that. You don't know what you're getting. Well, I ordered one from Amazon and it really wasn't working that well. The amount of water it was picking up off the ground, the amount of dirty water was very, very low. Which means basically, yes, it's scrubbing the floor, but it's leaving behind a lot of the dirty water because if it's not suctioning it up, it's no different than, you know, the Swiffer mops and stuff like that that just kind of move dirt around. I sent it back and I reordered it because I thought it was glitchy. And I noticed the other one had a manufacture date in 2020, I believe it was. It might have even been 2019. The replacement I got is this one. The manufacture date is 2021. This one is way better. I can only vouch for the ones that were built 2021 because this is the version that I have that's working well. This piece right here is much different and goes much further down to touch the ground than the previous one that I had. And that could be the issue. Overall, for me, the winner of this shootout was the iLife ShineBot. It's not without its issues, but with all these being at a similar price point, I feel like this one gives you the most bang for its buck. The glitchiness of the app is overshadowed by the fact that this one does the best cleaning of the floors. It's not really that difficult to maintain. It is a little bit set and forget. Once you get the app set up properly, it does a great pattern and actually gets to every portion of the floor. And if it doesn't, you can look at the app and see what it actually missed. I didn't have a major issue with it getting stuck on stuff, and I think overall it gives the best cleaning.